Hello, everybody, and welcome to a weird amalgamation of like a channel announcement, thank you, and show and tell video, where for your viewing pleasure, we will have some inquisition going on in the background. first off, I guess we all know that one of the biggest events of the year for me is coming up tomorrow, and it's Andromeda is coming out. Mass Effect Andromeda is coming out. And I did get the early access, but unfortunately I haven't even been able to play it. But I will be pre-ordering it today, and I will start playing tomorrow with the rest of you. So there's a lot of things that are going on, I guess, with this, is that lately you may have noticed I haven't been uploading any Witcher 3 videos, despite them being the most popular ones. And that's because I really just kind of didn't want to play anymore. It's a good game. I'm not saying it's not, and it's a good DLC. Like, I'm glad I finished the game. But a big part of the reason is that I've just been waiting for Andromeda to come out, and I really don't want to be tangled up with anything else. As much as I was trying to finish it, I was also just feeling pretty lackluster playing. Like, it was cool, but at the same time, I couldn't really motivate myself to play it. I just kind of needed a break from Witcher 3. And I wasn't able to get that with the timetable I had set for myself. But also, and this maybe is kind of an uncomfortable topic, I've been having some problems with depression lately. And so I'm not going to dwell on that. But yeah, it's been difficult to do things even I enjoy. It's been difficult to get out of bed in the morning, even to do fun things. So I know it's been off and on. Some of you maybe remember during the winter, and I'm like, oh, it's just a winter seasonal thing. But yeah, I've been having some financial problems and some personal problems that have all kind of culminated into sort of a depressive state. And today the only reason I could make this video is because I may have finally solved some of those problems. At least I'm very much on the track to doing so. Possibly have a much better job lined up. I've been saying that for a while, but these people sound like they really want me, and they told me to submit a resume and email them and let them know when I did it, and they're looking forward to like a lot of work this summer for archaeology, which is what I passionately want to do with my life, is archaeology. I don't want to be throwing packages around for the rest of my life, which is what I'm currently doing. So I've been in a bit of a funk about that, trying to find a new job, but the only reason I can make this again is because I may be have something lined up that will help me out a lot. So I'm really happy with that. So that aside, that has probably affected, I guess, not aside, I guess, but it has affected me not even wanting to play video games in general. The only ones I really wanted to do, basically all I wanted to do is play Overwatch because it's mind-numbing in many ways. But so I'm sorry about that. I will not be able to finish Hearts of Stone DLC, obviously, before Andromeda comes out. And once Andromeda comes out, that is all I will be playing for a long time. Except for on the live streams, which if you want to come, those have been a boon and a grace to me in these trying times. I seriously think everybody who's ever been able to pop in, even if you don't say anything, it's just nice to know that people are there hanging out and having a good time. And I'll probably continue playing Inquisition, the Trespasser DLC, which is what we're currently on. We're finishing up my second Inquisitor story, Talon, my elf assassin who's romancing Dorian. And I will finish that up on live streams and be uploading that periodically as well. But the second season of Mass Effect 3 might be put on hold for a little bit. There will maybe be days when I can just, you know, manage to power through some of it. But again, mostly I'm just really sorry that I haven't been able to keep a consistent upload schedule. It's been very sporadic, and I've been having a really hard time motivating myself to do even fun things, like I said. And it's just this constant stress of, you know, being able to pay the bills and finding work and everything. You guys know how it goes. You know how it goes. So I hope that you can understand my problems I've been having. I haven't handled it very well. I should have been able to, you know, buck up or whatever, you know, but it's difficult. So there were some days were better than others, obviously. And again, sorry to make this all like super personal or whatever, but it's just that I just wanted to make sure that you guys knew where I stood with the current game lineup. I will be putting Mass Effect 3 on hold with the replay of Raven Shepherd. apologize for my voice too currently. But the Hearts of Stone DLC will be, and the Blood and Wine obviously will be put on hold indefinitely. Not sure when I'll get back to those. When I'm feeling it, I'll get back to them. But I mostly want to focus on Andromeda for the foreseeable future. And I know some people have been saying some things about it, you know, but I've also heard positive things, and you know what? I don't care. It's going to be great. They tried, and that's what counts in a lot of things. And I have no doubt it's going to be an excellent game. In the environments look fantastic, and I'm excited to meet the characters, and I'm really excited. So that's what I'll be playing for the foreseeable future. The other problem is that the reason I haven't been able to play Andromeda, my early access version, yet is because I currently only have one laptop that I can play it on that has the specs that match even close, and that is the laptop I record on. And the problem with that is that I want to be able to put it on to my TV so that I can actually see what's going on and not just play on my laptop, you know, all hunched over. So I've been having to try, I'm looking into like getting an HDMI splitter and stuff because it's required for the recording software to have an HDMI input, but it's also required to have it to hook up to your TV to play. And I haven't been able to afford it, and I haven't been able to afford a new hard drive, a new external hard drive. But I'm hoping again I'm just going to right now, basically I'm just going to be spending what I have on bills and cords and hoping that things work out at the end of it. So I gotta go, hopefully later tonight, maybe early tomorrow, I'll be able to go and see if I can get an HDMI splitter and an external hard drive so that I can finally play the thing, because I really wanted to test it out and play with the character creator before the day of release so I could have a video out for you maybe. But it's not looking like it's gonna happen. Also, my current work schedule is just really weird. It's in the evening, and that's when I'm my most productive, and so it's really just throws me off. Throws off. Still, even though I've been working there for like 4 months, it still throws me off. So I do apologize for that as well. this has gotten long. But yeah, moral of the story is everything's gonna be on hold for now, except for Andromeda and occasional Inquisition videos, probably as I finish up Talon's story. Simply because it's easy to stream. Someone did ask if I could live stream Witcher 3, maybe. I don't like live streaming big story games that I haven't played before. I'm live streaming Inquisition because I've played it before all the way through, you know? So it's a little easier for me to pay attention to the chat, you know? But if I'm playing, it changes the way I play a game a little bit. And some of you have probably noticed when I'm live streaming Inquisition, you know, it's a little bit more scatterbrained, you know, because I'm busy talking and playing at the same time. It's not as focused as when I'm just recording. And for Andromeda, I will not be live streaming the main story of Andromeda for the same reason. I want to experience it firsthand myself without worrying about if I'm missing out on something somebody's saying. Plus, it's so new, a lot of you probably won't even watch the video that I'm going to upload because you don't want spoilers, and I 100% respect that, you know? So, I'm looking forward to playing with you guys in multiple ways. But I will possibly be streaming the multiplayer if I can get that to work, and we'll see if I what I think about that, I guess, but I'd like to maybe live stream some of the multiplayer. So that's the announcement part, basically. If you have any questions, let me know. I think I got everything. I won't be live streaming Witcher 3, and I won't be live streaming Andromeda main story, but I will be playing it, recording it, and possibly live streaming the multiplayer. I had several things I was going to address, but I hope I covered them all. Then, I guess, for the thank you part, I wanted to say thank you for over 1,000 subscribers. I was going to have a video, like, showing you guys my setup and stuff, but I think at this point, I couldn't get a good, decent video of it. At this point, the best I can do is maybe tell you what I have. What I currently have is an Xbox 360 and a little Alienware, it's called an Alpha console. If you want to look it up, they never really got any publicity. It's pretty good. It's only an i3 core, but it's run Witcher 3 on high graphics for me just fine. It could probably do better on a more monster machine, but I'm not a, you know, wealthy philanthropist or anything. But I like it. I'd probably next time just get a regular desktop. The Alienware is actually very compact, and I really like that. It's portable, compact. I really like that. I use a Titan surround sound headset that I've very much enjoyed for the last couple of years. I just have like a 32-inch flat screen TV with like no, well, oh, and in the Alienware, I have a plug-in mouse and keyboard, no big deal. I usually use my Xbox 360 controller for things, but then I guess the big stuff. Oh, and then my laptop that I run everything on is an HP i7 core, and that's been recording things beautifully. I very much enjoyed it. My old laptop was fine. It was just like a $400 laptop, was totally fine. I got this laptop thanks in many ways to you guys and your donations on Twitch. You guys basically paid for this thing. I got it on a Black Friday sale for like $400, and it was normally $800. But I really enjoyed it. It's very nice. It's been running everything quite smoothly. The only thing that I'm worried about is running Andromeda on it while also recording, because this is the only laptop I have that can play it, and it's also the only laptop I have that can record it decently. So that was what I wanted to test beforehand, but I've been unable to do so. So we'll have to see how that goes, especially with multiple cords and stuff like that. It's gonna be interesting. But yes, so that's what I have. And then I guess the biggest thing that you need if you want to start recording any gameplay whatsoever is a game capture card. And I use the Elgato HD. There's an HD 60 and like and blah blah blah. There's a bunch of different kinds now. But I've been using the HD for a couple of years, and I've loved it. It's been great. There have been some problems, but I think usually it's because of the computing powers of my prop, but the computing power of my laptop, that whatever computer I've got going at the time. I do use very expensive, nice HDMI cords. I believe they're the Monster brand. They're like gold plated, super thick, really nice. They were like 50 or $80 a pop, but there was screen tearing right very in the back. If you guys remember way back with the first Mass Effect 3 walkthrough, I had a lot of screen tearing problems, and that was because my HDMI cables were not good enough. They weren't. They were kind of messing with the data as it went through, after a while. One of my biggest things that I've learned about doing this is getting some really good cords and really good HDMI cords, if nothing else. And it's super easy to set up. All you have to do is have an HDMI that connects to the out on the Elgato. It's like it's as big as your palm, maybe. It's pretty small, and just a little bit thicker. And it just sits in the back of my setup. It's just very innocuous, it's very easy to use, and it plugs into the whatever gaming computer you're recording your games on, and then it plugs into the TV so that you can see what's going on. And then it also has a USB that plugs directly into the laptop or whatever computer that you're using to record. So like you have like your game that you're playing it on, you have your computer that you're playing on, and or the computer that you're recording on. I have them separate always. Either I'm recording on my 360 or the Alienware, or I'm playing on the 360 or the Alienware and recording on the laptop. But that's going to change with Andromeda, obviously. And then the next big thing is your microphone. I have a Blue Yeti microphone that I've been using. I think it's the Bluebell is really good, but I just have the Yeti, and I really like it. It's been really good. I don't even have like a. I should get like a little pop filter for it. That would maybe be nicer. But it's been a really good quality. Lots of people have said that they've thought that the quality of my voice recordings was really good as compared to maybe some other people who are just starting out. I spent about $100 on this because I wanted good quality stuff. So I spent money when I needed to. I spent over $1,000 getting a lot of this stuff. Getting it, I spent like 6 months, like just kind of gathering the materials, buying the TV, buying the game capture card and the computer and the microphone and stuff. And it's a pretty simple setup, honestly. Basically, you just need your, whatever you're gonna play on, the game capture card, and another thing to record it on, So I'm sorry I can't have a video for it. I don't have any high quality video taking like on like my camera or like my phone or anything, and it just is all bumpy and looked crap. So I guess if you have any more questions, let me know. I can take pictures maybe if you guys are more interested in that. I just know somebody for a long time ago asked if I could explain that. So That was probably too long of an explanation without pictures, but I'm terribly sorry about that. But I guess one last thing that I really wanted to do as a thank you was to show you guys some really cool stuff that I've gotten over the last year. And again, I cannot say thank you enough. But yes, as like a thank you to you guys again, because I can't stress enough how amazing it is to me that we've got like over 1,000 people here, and it's been crazy. I can't believe you guys are all here hanging out, and then so many of you seem to like really enjoy the videos I put out, and I honestly enjoy making them, and it bums me out when I not feeling well enough to make them, because I know that many of you enjoy them and I enjoy interacting with you with that through them. And again, just thank you for everything. I owe you guys a lot. I really do. And I hate to disappoint you all. So I hope that you are still enjoying what I'm doing, and that you'll enjoy what's going to happen in the future, whatever the future holds. I hope we're all in it together. And yeah, so I thought I'd show you guys some cool stuff that I've gotten over the years, or over this, basically just this last year. Probably, I guess the first picture will probably be a picture that I've commissioned. So well, let me explain first. I really love, back when I had a real job, I loved commissioning art from artists online. Usually I'm from Tumblr. I'd just go on and look at cool pictures, and if they had commissions up, I'd go commission them. So, and I really love and appreciate art. I sketch a little bit on my own. I do some watercolor every now and then, but I just love art. I love it to pieces. It's great. And I love supporting people who are actual artists, you know, who actually can draw and stuff. So I guess the first thing that I'll show you is a commission I did from, or I'll try to put links in the description. If I don't tonight, I'll try to do it by tomorrow. But her name is Mass Effects on Tumblr. But her commissions are through like lucy.commissions@gmail.com, I think. And again, I'll try to put, if I don't get links up tonight, I will definitely get links up tomorrow, because artists deserve credit for their work. It doesn't matter who or what it is, they deserve credit for their work. And I, just to be clear, I didn't do any of this. Any of this art that I'm going to show, not mine. The first one is a picture I commissioned from Lucy on Tumblr, and it's Durthara Serana from Dragon Age Origins. And it's probably one of my favorites. It's probably my favorite, maybe, I don't know. But it's beautiful. I love it. It's the funny thing is I actually have most everything currently up on my wall. Because I get permission from the artist to, because it's usually digital, right? And they'll send it to you, and then I print it and I hang it up on the wall in a frame. And so currently she's hanging up on the wall as well. I really love the detail on like her face, her eyes. It's just, I kind of wanted the feel for it to be like she's about to head into a battle. So she's got like lightning getting ready, because I had her specialize in lightning. She's got kind of lightning crackling up her staff and over her. And the two feathers are, one's a crow for Zevran, and for like representing Zevran. And this is like super like, you know, a headcanony or whatever, you know. They're just black feathers, basically. But one is also supposed to represent a raven for Durthamin, because I feel like even though she was a city elf, basically, that was taken, I feel like in my head she was half Dalish and grew up hearing stories of the Dalish, and the god that she most was interested in, partly because of her name, was Durthamin, the god of secrets. So she's a Durthara means like a seeker of knowledge and secrets. So yeah, I really love that piece. It's one of my favorites. The next one's from the same artist, and it's Irika Lavellen from Dragon Age Inquisition. And this one was really cool. She did unfortunately have to rush a little bit because the artist was moving and everything, but she's so good, and she's so prompt and quick, and she's just really good at, I love her art. I can't wait to commission her again. But it's Irika. It's a little bit more of a mobile, less of a portraity thing. It's more of a mobile piece, you know, where it looks like she started to slightly turn. For me, it's post events of Trespasser. And she's wearing Solas's wolf jawbone necklace, and it's kind of outlined in fade magic, just kind of shimmering with it. And she's got the sword on her back is Certainty, my favorite sword from the series. And she looks phenomenal. I love it. Her hair, the lighting, I love the light. The background was actually inspired. I sent her a couple pictures, the artist, a couple pictures of the Crestwood area where Solas does his thing and breaks your heart, you know? So in my head, she went there one last time after the events of the Inquisition to maybe see if she could pick up anything, any clue, maybe to say goodbye or something, to like, just, it's, it was like the first step on her journey after Inquisition. Like, her, you know, her arm is gone, and it's just, it's a new journey for her. It's a new, not like an adventure, but it's a new mission, a new goal to find him. So that's her getting ready. Oh, and the armor is actually from the Inquisition art book. What's it called? Concept art for elves. So if you have that or want to look it up, it is an armor style that was from the concept art for an elf inquisitor in the Dragon Age Inquisition book. So yes, there's that. The next couple pieces that I will show are from another commission that I did on Tumblr from someone who goes by Queen, Witch Tricks, I think. Again, I'll try to link it. But I commissioned her last year, and it was the most expensive commission I'd done, but it was well worth it. She's a very talented artist. And she's put a lot of work and detail into it. And it's, I just got it the other day, which I thought was very momentous. And it's my Commander Shepherd, my Raven Shepherd, my original love of my life Shepherd that I just couldn't be happier with. You know what I mean? And she's the one that we've been playing with in the original series and in the rerun. But yeah, she's also the one who is my icon, my YouTube icon right now, my little avatar picture or whatever. That one I commissioned from Destiny Apostasy, which is right. Hopefully I'm showing it to you right now, but you've probably seen it. I had a little video announcing it and everything. I was very excited. But this piece is by a different artist, and she did two pieces. Well, what she did one. I commissioned one, and basically the first one that I'm probably showing right now is Mass Effect. It has a Mass Effect 3 title on it, right? Because I wanted it to kind of look like the Mass Effect 3 poster, and what I want to do with it still is print out a small version and put it on my Xbox 360, hard copy, as like to replace the old cover, just for my personal preference. That'd be cool, to have my Shepherd on the cover, And then, very kindly, when I asked, she also provided me with a copy that didn't have the title on it, and that is just kind of this epic, poster stare down or whatever. Not a poster, because the poster has like a title on it, but it's more of a personal, it doesn't look so like a game cover, it looks more maybe like an artwork or something. I don't know, it's all artwork, but you know what I mean. There are two different versions, and I like them both, and I was very glad that she was willing to give me both. And I might print out the one without a title on my wall because it's beautiful. And I was just so, so happy that look at the armor and everything. Like, it's gorgeous. It was so cool. It was very cool. And I was very excited with it. And then the other thing I commissioned was my icon, which we've seen. Probably the next one I'll show is a couple pieces that I got from a couple Comic Cons that I went to. And the first one is going to be of Solas, and that's just one that the artist didn't have. She had some Dragon Age pieces, but she didn't have a picture of Solas. But when I asked her if she had one, she said she didn't have a print ready for Comic-Con, but she'd be more than willing to draw me one. And so she did, and she gave it to me the next day, and I love it. It looks really cool. I really like it. So, and it's the Trespasser version of him, right? The Dread Wolf with the moon and everything. And I was just, so excited. Again, I'll have to look up. I don't remember the names for this one, but I still have. I have for the Comic-Con people artists. I have their cards still. Let me see. Actually, I do. I know for sure for the next one I have her card, and this is a different artist. It's the same kind of paper, but I've noticed that Comic-Con artists, they bring this kind of paper with them to just kind of sketch on. And this next one is of Erica, and this one I was blown away by because this her name is Bree at Work. Bree Jordan, and she's an illustration and comic artist. I'm looking at her card. I happen to have it, right in one of my drawers right next to me. And her Tumblr is brieatwork@.tumblr.com. So go check her out if you want. I think she said she's more active on Twitter. But she did manage to do this drawing of Erica, which is the most, honestly looks more like Erica than anything else I've ever seen. And she did it with I asked her if she could do an original piece because she said that she on her boards that she could, and she said yes. What happened is that they didn't have a picture of Erica on me. I went to YouTube, I paused the YouTube video on a part with her face, right? We're like really up close, like at the beginning of the game. And then I showed it to her and she took a picture of it with her phone. And I told her I would like the Dalish warrior armor. And she could only find some fuzzy pictures of it. But she said, yeah, those will be good. Come back in a couple of hours. And I came back in a couple of hours and she had made this. Like, I don't know how she did it, but she was fantastic, and it's beautiful. It's one of my favorites, again. It's probably my favorite of Erica. It's really, really nice. I was blown away that she could do that in such a short amount of time. But yeah, wow, this is getting long. But anyway, I have a couple more that I want to show you guys that people have just made for me. Some man flesh on Twitter, and he also comes to the Twitch. He has been so incredibly kind and gave me 4 different pieces just for free that he just gave me, and that he was painting like on like live streams and stuff. And I am blown away by his kindness and his style and his just, it's beautiful. It's amazing. And I was like, I'll pay you for it if you want. But he just gave it to me out of the kindness of his heart. And I could not be happier. But their first one's going to be, it's a painting of Talon. And it's, I believe this one comes with the two different filters. And I love them both. And then another one has, oh no, it wasn't 4, it's more than 4, geez. He also made one with Dorian and Talon, who are like flirting, and that's paint, by the way, not the blood of their enemies. And I was so excited because he just kept, Talon's got a very sharp angled face, and it's the first artwork I've ever seen of Talon. I haven't been able to commission anything of Talon yet, even though I love him to pieces. And I was over the moon with it. And so he did Dorian and Talon, and I was so excited. And they look so cute together. And then he also, just to break my heart even further, made one with Erica and Solas. And this one has the 2 different filters as well. And they're both beautiful. And it's so sad and poignant, and it's just makes my heart ache for whatever is in their future, you know, and the lighting and the color and like the elves are hard to draw, like some of them, and like they've got like weird, like Talon especially has a very angled face, and the Valislein on both of them is just time consuming, you know. I've tried drawing both of them and it's very difficult. So I just cannot respect artists more. I think they're phenomenal, and I couldn't be happier. And I know Pinky Fox Ashley from Twitch, she made my cute little donation button that I have now, because before it was just this ugly giant donate button and I hated it. But she made this cute little squirrel one that was adorable. And she also gave it a Christmas hat for winter. And it was really, really cute. A little Santa hat for winter time. It was really cute. And I know at least one other person, Seshu, is showed us a work in progress of a sketch that he was working on for me. Of Talon, and I was just like, oh my gosh, you people spoil me. And Pinky Fox Ashley again, and one of her friends is also, they were doing like a really cool banner thing that they started for me. And again, they may not, the people who are doing the work, I don't mean to call out the work in progress people at all, like you never have to show me anything, but I just want to recognize that you even started something for me. And it was beautiful. They're amazing. You guys are amazing artists, and I am blessed by the multitude of talent that surrounds me in my online friends. So I am very, very grateful for everything that everybody has given me, for that I've gotten and everything. I think that's all. I hope I'm not missing anything that anybody's done for me. If you guys have any art you want me to show, like, if you're ever like, I wonder if I should draw something, I would be over the moon. Like, I will make these videos regularly and, like, showcase people's art, because I think art is so awesome and deserves every recognition it can get. And I will, when if I ever get money and you guys want me to commission you, I will commission you. But when I have money, I don't think artists should necessarily give away their art for free. If they do out of the kindness of their hearts, that's fine. But people who want to make a living on their art deserve well past reasonable pay, you know, like recompense or whatever, compensation for their work. You know, it's hard work, and it's well worth whatever whatever price they ask. Sometimes it's worth more than what they ask. So I really do appreciate everybody who's ever given me anything, and I appreciate anybody who's ever given me any kind words or just laughed with me or cried with me or hasn't even, you don't have to say anything. Just the fact that you're watching my videos and hopefully enjoying what I'm doing is just a boon to me, and I cannot thank you enough. And sorry for how long this has gotten. Hopefully it's okay. And hopefully I will see you guys in the next couple of days with some Andromeda footage. So until then, if you have any questions, let me know. You can follow me on Twitter. I do tend to respond a little bit quicker on there. It's a little bit easier for me to respond to comments on Twitter, because for some reason the YouTube keeps making its comment system more and more convoluted and complicated to respond. So if you ever want to, you can follow me on Twitter. You can follow me on Twitch too. We do live streams every Wednesday and Saturday at about 10 or 11 a.m. Mountain Standard Time. The links for those are in the description. And once again, thank you all, and I hope you're having a fantastic day.